Okay? What did Imam Ahmed also do as well? As you can see on screen, we've got the book, Manhaj al-Salaf, fi fahmi nususi, bayna nadariyati wa tatbiq. That the Manhaj al-Salaf, they keep saying Manhaj al-Salaf, but the Manhaj al-Salaf to them is basically the Najd al-Dawah, which the Manhaj al-Salaf is free from. And this is written by Sayyid Muhammad bin Alawi, al-Maliki, al-Makki, al-Hasani. Okay? And he is a khadim al-ilm, al-sharif, bi balad al-haram. And he's also a sheikh from the haram as well. He's a Maliki, and he's a Makki, and he's a Hassani from the Ahl al-Bayt. Okay? And he wrote this book.
From the Ahl al-Bayt. From Ahl al-Bayt. All right, Tayyib. First of all, of course, he's not telling his audience. Ajib, isn't it? An Athari quoting someone who is a hardcore Khurafi Sufi. MashaAllah. So it's already a red flag. No, we're not going to discount his argument because of the source. That would be a logical fallacy. That's what he has done in the past. However, it's a big red flag already, right? So let's continue.
Now, he mentioned, as you can see on screen, he mentioned that Imam Ahmed, okay, Imam Ahmed, used to do ghusl of the shirt, okay, of Imam al-Shafi'i, rahmatullah alayhi. So he used to wash his shirt, his qamis, and he used to drink the water from the ghusl of Imam al-Shafi'i.
Subhanallah.
Okay, so a Sayyid, well, I always forget his name because it's lengthy. A Sayyid Muhammad bin Alawi al-Maliki.
Look at this dajjalism, charlatanism, as if the name is of any importance. It's long. The miskeen, I know for a fact that he's been fed these khurafat, and he doesn't even know. He can't even pronounce a single Arabic word correctly, let alone understanding proper Arabic. And the people he's quoting, he doesn't even know who he's quoting.
Makki al-Hasani, rahmatullah alayhi, okay? Basically confirmed Imam Ahmed, okay?
Ooh, confirms, tayyib. Someone from the 20th century confirmed that Imam Ahmed did what?
To wash the shirt, the qamis of Imam al-Shafi'i, and the water that used to drip from it, he used to drink it, okay? He used to drink it to seek tabarruk, okay? Imam Ahmed bin Hanbal got nothing to do with the Neo-Salafi.
Well, Imam Ahmed bin Ahlul Sunnah wa Jama'ah, Ahlul Athar, Salafiyya have definitely nothing to do with Imam Ahmed bin Hanbal. I don't know who that is. Ahlul Sunnah have everything to do with Imam Ahmed bin Hanbal. هذا أولا. ثانيا, you see, it's shocking. The intellectual dishonesty is shocking. And I tell you why. He did not just quote a 20th century Sufi Khurafi authority. That's already bad enough. The Sufi authority, because it doesn't mean that every Sufi or every Rafidi is always lies by default. No, we can't argue based on that. However, look at the screen. The Sufi himself did not provide any chain for this fabrication. The fabrication that, you know, Imam Ahmed, rahimahullah, had nothing better to do than slurp the sweat water of Imam Shafi'i for the sake of seeking tabarruk, blessings. You know why? Because there is no chain for this fabrication. It's a late fabrication, huh? Chainless. And that's the same person who claims he's educating the masses straight from the sources. And he does research, and that's again one of his many small mistakes, right? I don't think so. He is obviously incapable to do proper talab and research, bahth, because his manhaj, his ilm, his aqidah, his manhaj, everything is poor and weak, lack of Arabic, and so on and so forth. So the bare minimum is for him to apologize, not to me and the Najdis, Najdiya, to apologize to you, to the masses, to those he claims he's educating. Sometimes he releases a half-baked apology, correction on one of when he tweets or whatnot. But he always keeps the videos up. He must put his video down about Imam Ahmed claiming that Imam Ahmed slurped sweat water. He can either put the whole video down or he can cut it. There are options. There's no excuse.